Okay, part two. Hello, internet. This is Olin from What I'm Listening To. I am back once again with the bag of mysteries here. If you haven't done so already, go ahead and watch part one of this. It explains why I'm doing this and what the whole point is, or you can watch and figure it out for yourself. So let's just jump right into it. Seven albums, here we go. First one from the bag here. There we go. This one. Okay, Florence and the Machine. This is the band's first album, Lungs, and this is actually the deluxe edition with a second disc full of tons of extra stuff. My former manager actually gave me a copy of this CD. She let me put it on my iTunes so I could listen to it. So I've known about the album for a while now, but I just never owned a proper physical copy of it. I actually got this album specifically for the song You've Got the Love. That song would come on all the time before we started playing Christmas music at work, and I would just get it stuck in my head. The XX does a remix, a cover, I don't know what you want to call it, but their take on it is insane and so good. You got the love, you got the love, you've got the love. But the original version is much more soulful, which I didn't really appreciate until recently when I would keep hearing it at work. And me being me, I don't like getting standard editions, knowing that there are deluxe editions with extra stuff, particularly if that extra stuff is B-sides. I'm not really about getting deluxe editions that are all demos or all live recordings, but this has B-sides, live recordings, and demos, so it's got quite a bit of good things on here. But You've Got the Love is not just the best song on here. Dog Days Are Over is another one of my favorites on here. I'm Not Calling You a Liar is a good one. Drumming Song, another good one. She's fantastic, the band is fantastic. This is a cool record, and happy to own this one finally. You got the love, you got the love, you. Okay, next up in the bag here. Alright, here we go. Another Cymbals Eats Guitars album. I talked about them in the last mystery bag video. I bought basically all of their albums, other than Lose, which is the one I already owned. And I bought them because I was loving Lose so much. This one is actually probably my other favorite album. This is their second one, Lenses Alien. Their first album is more raw and punky sounding. They're basically just kind of establishing their sound. This album, they start going into more noisy, shoegaze, psychedelic realms, and it's fucking awesome. Lose has a mixture of different songs. There's a couple songs that are more psychedelic, particularly the song Laramie, which I think is phenomenal. I was craving more songs like that one, and when I heard this album, I was like, yes, this is it. This is what I've been looking for. It's melodic, it's noisy, it's everything that I love, and alone, the cover is super cool too. If you're a fan of the band and you haven't heard this record for whatever reason, definitely check this one out. It's so good, and I love this band so much, so I'm so glad that I ended up paying the money for it. Get on the gig, close together. Lights on the face from the labor of light is fading. Alright, next one in the bag. Oh, here we go. Alright, so half Japanese. This is actually a duo between two brothers, Jad Fair and David Fair. They do these weird lo-fi recordings that are very outsider sounding and very thought-provoking too. Jad is pretty notorious in the punk world. He's collaborated with quite a few musicians. Daniel Johnston is actually one of the guys, and that's also the reason why I know who Half Japanese are. They have quite a bit of records out there, so it was a little hard to choose from. Ultimately, I opted out to get the greatest hits here, and mostly because it has the song Put Some Sugar on it. It's probably their most accessible song just because of its melody and it's catchy. The rest of the songs on here can range from being loud and noisy and weird, but it's all for the sake of being loud and noisy and weird. I think the point of the band was to make a statement, much like punk was in general, to make a statement. These guys did their own take on punk, and it's done in a very weird way, and it's still very cool. So yes, this is only 34 songs out of their massive discography. After listening to this, I might have to go out and get a proper release. But until then, I'll be enjoying the recordings on this one.
Put some honey on it, sugar. I like it sweet, baby. Oh, baby.
Alright, let's see, next up in the bag here. Ooh, yes, this is a great one. The Brian Jonestown Massacre. This is their very, very first album, Methadrone. It's probably my favorite album of theirs. They're a band that have done all kinds of different sounds. They've done twangy country blues, they've done psychedelic rock, and on this one, their very first album, they do shoegaze. I don't think this was intended to be categorized as shoegaze, but ultimately it made lists that were considering it one of the best shoegaze albums of all time, and for good reason, because it's amazing. The first track, Evergreen, is one of my favorites on here. It's slow, but insanely emotional. Wisdom is also a great track on here. And then That Girl Suicide has this amazing guitar twang that explodes into noise, and it's fantastic. Anton Newcomb, the guy behind the band, is really, really wacky dude, but he's a brilliant songwriter, brilliant musician. If you don't know this band, check this album out, and then also go check out the documentary Dig. That gives everybody a bit of an insight of how they interacted with one another and their recording process. They were nuts. In both good and bad ways, but this is an amazing documentation of their work. It's a great record. Okay, next in the bag here. Oops. Oh, alright. Alright, this is The National, the Virginia EP. So this is actually an EP and a movie packaged together. I mainly bought this for the EP because I think the only way you can get it is if you buy the movie. But in my mind, a documentary about The National with music, that's a pretty good bargain, so I got it. This was filmed when they were recording their album Boxer, which I want to say was the album that really got them famous. It's got a couple of B-sides on here that didn't make the album, Santa Clara, Blank State. It's also got a great song on here, You've Done It Again, Virginia, which is probably one of my favorite National songs. And then it's got an assorted amount of demos on here, and then some live cuts. They even do a cover of Bruce Springsteen's Mansion on the Hill. I've talked about them in the past. They're one of my favorite bands. They're wonderful, they're emotional, they're beautiful. And now I have a cool little film to accompany a cool little EP, so I'm excited to own this.
Well, you've done it again, Virginia. Made another masterpiece while I was dreaming. How does it feel to feel like you? Brilliant sugar, brilliant.
Next up in the bag, this one. Ooh, alright. Low. I've talked a lot about this band. I think I talked about them in the Double Up vlogs. It seems like anytime I buy a Low record, I end up buying multiple Low records later on. This was one of the many Low records that I bought within a short period of time. This is Secret Name. This is an album I'd been meaning to get after hearing the album Things We Lost in a Fire, which is my favorite Low record. It's got two things I love. It's released off the Cranky label, and it's produced by Steve Albini, which Things We Lost in a Fire also had those two things. Their music is gorgeous, it's emotional, it's an interesting take on slowcore, the pussy side of slowcore, if you want to call it that, but I fucking love this band. I saw them live and it made me love them even more, so I'm slowly but surely gonna get all of their albums. So owning this one makes me one step closer. I'm excited to officially own it, and I can go listen to this and cry to myself. Load the back and you can drive. Okay, last album for this video. Let's see, is it gonna be a good one? I don't know. Alright, last one, we have Bjork. Bjork has always been on my radar, but she has so many albums that it's really, to me, difficult to pick one to start. Ultimately, I opted out for one of her two most famous records. This is the album Post. The reason I got this record is because it has the only Bjork song I really know. It's Oh So Quiet. I don't think that's an accurate representation of her music because it's very swing, jazz-oriented. The rest of the album has some amazing production. It's like trip-hop and deep-sounding and weird, but it's really cool. She's got such a great voice, and it's just such an artsy-sounding record. It's very 90s sounding, but good 90s. My girlfriend is also the reason I got it, because she was saying how she hadn't really heard much Bjork and wanted to check it out, so I bought this for the both of us to listen to. I don't think she was as big of a fan of it as I was, but I like a lot of weird sounding music, so I enjoyed this a little bit more. I'll probably end up going out and getting another Bjork record at some point, but until then, I'll be enjoying this one. And if you complain, once more you'll be down, I'm love you. Alrighty, internet, that does it for me. Hey, if you have any albums or bands you want me to go check out, leave a comment down below, and if I like them, maybe I'll feature them in a vlog or put them in the mystery bag. But until then, this is Olin from What I'm Listening To signing out. Goodbye.